So a very pleasant morning to one and all present here. So happy to see many people have joined through webinar and a few interesting candidates, students who are sitting in front of me to listen to my seminar on effective way of developing final year project. So the topic itself gives you a clear picture. Everybody does a final year project, but there is a way which is an effective way of developing a final year project. And I'll be guiding you through the process. So any queries, any questions, lift your hands up. I'll be in a position to help you. So this is Manoj, and on behalf of TTA, I'm going to take a seminar. It's going to give you guidance on your final year project. It's not to enhance my profile. It's just to keep you people updated. What is the exposure that I have towards the industry? I have 10 years of experience in IT industry. I worked on various software projects, both in India and abroad. I have good exposure in handling real-time projects, basically from getting the requirements till it has been put into the production environment. I'm a speaker, mentor, and product consultant for TTA. And I also spend most of my time with student friends in developing their ideas. I have strong knowledge in SDLC and Agile methodologies, and project freak like who gets involved in latest technologies like cloud hosting, big data, and ethical hacking. So hopefully, whatever the projects that you people do, I'll be the mentor in TTA in guiding you throughout the process. So let's see why we have to do a project and how to execute a project in the coming slides. Objective. First, once your college, I request you people to do a final year project, understand the importance of a final year project. The project not only fetches you marks, the project also helps you people to get a job. In IT industry, once we go for interviews, we really see the project, what you people have done, your contribution to the project, and how effective the project have developed. So the importance of the project is not for marks, it is for getting you your first job or your dream job. The very important thing, follow the IT process, how we develop a project in IT industry, the same way you people can also follow all the methods that we use in IT industry. And probably it will help you during the interviews. And most important, do your project, don't buy a project. So with minimal guidance or people who can give expertise support, you people should be able to do the project. Hopefully, the objective is very clear. Final year projects are not for marks. The final year projects are for knowledge and for your job. So based on this particular input, let's move through the coming slides. Why to do a project? We are engineering grads. On day one, we'll be deployed into job. You people have to work in IT projects. So the project will give you how to apply the knowledge that you have gained in your education. Last 4 years, you people have a lot of subjects. Rather than knowing what is the subjects that we have learned, probably we'll be trying to get more marks, try to clear our arrears and so on. But project is one area where marks is not a matter. It can boost your grade. But knowledge that you people are gaining will definitely help you during the interviews and also to work in IT industry. Project will give you a clear picture how to do problem solving. And during the project, you people will get touch base with a lot of new tools which you people have never done during your education. Practical experience is very important thing that you people will gain. And very important, the learning that you people are going to take away is about IT process, documentation, testing, and deployment, how they do in IT industry. So a project has five different steps which fetches you knowledge. The first thing, how to select a project is a problem for everyone. Identify a real-time problem. IT has solution for everything. So problem, you should select a problem and not a project. Identify a problem and we will come up with a solution in IT. The first phase, once you have a problem, discuss with your guide, discuss with your friends, discuss with the end user, customers, or anybody that you people take. First thing is you people should do something called requirement analysis. Why I should do the project? Once you do requirement analysis, there are four different categories that you people should do requirement analysis. System analysis, the basic requirements, knowledge of domain or technical area that is required. Organizational behaviors, knowledge on industry, what exactly they are expecting in the industry. Product or user experience, process requirement analysis. Once requirement analysis have been done, you people should go for non-functional aspects. So how you are going to do the project? whether what is the UI that I'm going to use, efficiency, scalability, performance, security, maintainability, fault tolerance, portability, documentation, compliance, and testability. So basically, once we do a project, we go to a project center and get some project papers, submit to our guide, we get it approved, and then we do. But we don't look into these kind of aspects. But once you people strictly follow, like how efficiently that we can develop, or whether the project is scalable. Once I do this project, whether my juniors will be able to take this project for a next step, it's called a scalability. The time that is required is very, very important. It comes under performance. And if security can also be implied in your project, once the project has been developed, definitely this project will fetch you a job. And IT industry is looking for people who take care of all these non-functional aspects rather than showing the output and then getting the marks. So other than the output, also take care of this non-functional aspects once you are developing your final year project. Do a design. The design should be very simple. It should be a design that can be applicable directly in IT and it can be developed very easily. So there are a few things called high-level design and low-level design. A high-level design talks about architecture, like based on the technology that you are going to do, what is the database that you are going to select, how exactly the flow is going to be maintained is high-level design. Low-level design is about the classes. What are the classes? You can write some pseudocode. You can do a POC, proof of concept. Do a simple module, test it, try to see whether the entire project can be done. And design documents are quite easy. You can even do reverse engineering, like using rational rows. You can design the product development or flow, and even the code can be regenerated by redesigning it. So design plays very important role. Don't go blindly. Get the first page done by using a JSP and show a login page during your project reviews. Have a clear-cut design. Take your time. Once design is perfect, you people will be able to complete your project. I have a question to all of you people. Can you people walk in water? Yes? Oh, so it's a big no from everyone. Like everybody are telling that we can't walk in water. But in IT, we used to tell we can walk in water. But only thing, it has to be freezed. Once water becomes ice, you people will be able to even walk on top of the water. The same thing, don't change the design. Design has to be freezed. Because students, I normally see during each review, they change their requirements. From the beginning, they change everything. The problem is that you haven't properly designed. So once you design properly, it's like freezing the requirements. Talk with your guide, talk with your HOD, try to come with a problem solution and then freeze the requirements. Once the requirements has been freezed, you will have a proper design. And normally once the design is proper, you'll be able to execute the project in a very efficient way. Selecting a better design, collection of design documents, design study, analysis, security requirements, design changes, discuss all these with your team and do a design finalization. Very simple. Conduct a meeting like that we do in IT industry. Take all your friends or your project mates to a cabin. Do a detailed design. The very important thing, the place that you have never visited is your library. Better go. Take some design related books. Have a discussion. Come with a conclusion how to do a proper design document and then do a design finalization. And there should be a team leader in your project who should approve the design which is final. Get an approval from your HOD and also from your project guide such that the design is freeze. So now you people are right now gearing up for your project. So now it is coding. So you have a proper design. So let's do some coding part. Implementation. As I told you, once we have done requirements and design, implementation and unit testing, probably the technology that you people are comfortable with, let it be Java, .NET or any of the technology. Take one of your thing, do your own coding, have some contribution. All the four people in your team, or if there are three or two people, or it's a single project, you people should contribute either in a small way, let it be onto a database side or into a development area, try to implement it. Implementation is very simple once you know the technology. So in TTA, what we do, we train candidates on how to do proper coding. We have some standards in Java and .NET. We help you people in learning the technology such that your project is implemented by yourself and you feel that this is my project and I have designed this particular web page and it's live in internet. Testing is very important. 100 times we review our papers, the exam papers that we write, we will not find even a single mistake. But once it goes to our staff members, what happens? Lot of red inks. More than blue inks, we'll find red inks over there. The only reason because they test it, they check it. So testing is very important. Though we develop the project, You have to give it to other candidates, like it can be your friends or it can be a technology oriented person. Do a full round of testing so that during the deployment phase or once it goes live into production, you will not face any issues. This is the project lifecycle that we follow in IT. It follows an SDLC, a typical SDLC lifecycle model. And all the final year projects that we do in TTA, we also follow this particular requirements. You choose a base paper, you have to come out with requirements. We help you in doing a design. We teach you to do coding and you people will test it and you people are going to deploy it. Don't think, sir, how can I do it? I am very sure it's a very simple project application that you people are going to do, an IEEE paper. You people will be able to do it, and in TTE, we support you to do all these phases. And this gives you more confidence once you people come into IT, and the same process is being done even in IT industry. Testing, these are the steps that is involved: planning, development, execution, reporting, defect, retesting, regression, test closure. So we have different test plans that has been created as per IT standards and all has been documented. So once you complete your programming, all this testing will be done by you people and these documents can also be added in your project report. Hope you people will do a testing and it's not that your HOD identifies a mistake or your staff members identify a mistake. We ourselves will identify the mistakes, the bugs. We learn from the mistakes and we correct it up. So in IT, once you people have guts to fix up any issues, no other issues can come and block your code. So during your review, people can be very free because it has been bug free and it has been tested by a very good tester. It's none other than you. Defect handling, bug in your code. Don't worry. Try to see whether the same kind of errors are again and again, it is getting repeated or reproducing. Analyze what is the input that you people are giving. Identify the problematic area. Do a quick fix. Quick fix is nothing but which can be immediately fixed and tested. And the problem will be in your code. And by debugging concepts that TTA teaches you, you people will be able to fix it up. All the tools, as you people can see in the slides, what I have shown, that you people might have used these words in your resumes, but in TTA, we teach you people how to work onto it. And programming languages, operating system, database, the cloud, the editors, the IDEs, everything are very recent technologies that we teach you people. And probably you people will have a hands-on and you people will explore and learn new tools while doing your project. And these kind of words that you people put in your profile or resume will definitely is going to be adding an edge to work in top level MNCs in India and abroad. Benchmarking. We also take one step ahead of all the final year projects that we do. We see how much is the performance, the usage of RAM and CPU cycles that is happening. We also help you people in breaking point of your solution, and there is no limitation. We have a benchmarking. We see to that whether all the standards have been met. Standard compliance. It depends upon the project that you people do. Validate everything against the test suite. Follow all the Java standards or whatever the programming language that you people use and try to create a compliance report. Always, the project is not an end. The project will also have something to be implemented in future. So we should give away whatever we tried due to our time. We may not be able to complete few of the future work. Give suggestions very clearly what exactly can be done so that your project can be taken by some other people in future. It can be your juniors, it can be any other people, and there should be scope of improvement in your thing. If performance can be improved or the way that we have coded or whatever the way of improvement or technology or the latest tools that we can use or the project itself, the design itself can be revisited. Give some future inputs, what you haven't tried, what other people can do. Be a show, provide some inputs so that future work can be done by your juniors. Report generation. It's not that we give a book, you people print. Whatever you people do in each phase of the project, it's been properly documented. And all these documents will be put into a report generation and you people will have a clear-cut report. At any point in time in future, you people refresh this report, you people will know how much effort that you people have put in creating this particular project, and probably it will also give you a clear-cut idea that you people are ready to work in IT industry. So teamwork is one important soft skill that we will learn. Two or more people, everybody should contribute. Listen more, motivate and energize. Learn some new ideas. Once the project is being delivered and you people have your project, using the team, try to improve more things in your project. And as a team, the teamwork is very important once you people do a project. So all the people, it's not a money contribution that you people should make. Equally money has been divided for a project. It's about equally the knowledge and skill of you people have been done. So a good team that you people create for a project, better team, the same team can win a better job. So I request all you people who are over here, I hope your teammates have also been here in this webinar, and I see a lot of people laughing at each other. So probably like it's about whatever the skills that you have, project has all the contributions that you people can make, and team building at the end of the project, you people should be very happy that you people have created a good team, which have completed a deliverable project, a quality project from TTA. Project and resume, just try to enhance all this, whatever you people have done in your project, in your profile, which will be definitely helpful for a job. And in TTA, these are the benefits that you people are going to get. As I told you people, cloud hosting has been done, SDLC lifecycle model that we follow. And we have a lot of IT people who help you people in developing a project. We have videos, we have base paper explanation, we do give reference papers. And you people get all the free soft skills, aptitude and technology training for free. Project support, the documents follow IT process. And all these diagrams have been done by you people and probably will be in a position to support you. All eligible candidates can approach TTA for placement. And whenever you people take up a course with project, and you people can get a free internship letter, and also you people will get a project at free of cost. This is our address, TTA number 29, Dr. Noy Road, T-Nagar. And for any projects, any support, any queries, I expect you people to contact me at manoj@talhan.co.in, or you people can log into www.ttafinallyaprojects.com. or reach us at the below numbers. Hope this session was useful. We'll be more happy to interact with you people in future. All the very best. Create your own project, convert your ideas, and hopefully I can meet you people in the biggest MNCs of the world. Wish you all the best. Thank you for listening. This is Manoj signing off from TTA.